In today's webinar, I'll take you through the part one of add-on modules of Fedina. These are the list of topics that we'll be seeing for today's webinar. Let me begin this session with Data Palette module. Before we begin this session, we need to enable the plugin in the Accounts panel. I'm going to my Accounts panel. I'm selecting my school. And in the plugins option, I need to enable the plugin data palette. Right here, I've enabled the plugin data palette and I'm saving it. Now, in my school, I can view the dashboards here. In this dashboard, I can arrange my dashlets. To manage my dashlets, I need to go for the option Manage Dashlet. Right here, Fedina is giving you these options. You can select these options, select any of these options to customize your dashboard. In case if you want to view the examinations, absentee student, leave applications, the news and the placement option that is happening for today, any fees due or financial transaction, the birthdays of students, the timetable, the release students. So these options are all right here. You can enable the ones that you want to see in your dashboard. By enabling these and saving it, you can customize your own dashboard. This dashboard will not provide you a shortcut, but then it will allow you to view the happenings of today in the institutions. So right here you can see the fees due and the batch. Similarly, you can see the timetable for today with the time and the subject and the batches. The leave applications that is applied for today will be seen here. The examination that is planning to be conducted for today can be seen here. The module themes. Before knowing about themes module, we need to enable the plugin in the admin panel. I have enabled the plugin right here, theme. Once I've done, I'm saving it. I'm going to my Fedina page. To find the theme plugin, I need to go to Administration, Settings, General Settings. Inside which, I can find the option to select my theme. I can customize my Fedina school by selecting any of these themes and by changing the font as well. Once you have done selecting this, you need to update it. Now you know how to use the theme plugin. The next module that we have to do is Moodle. Moodle is a learning management system which can be integrated with Fedina. To enable Moodle, we need to enable the plugin in the Accounts panel. In the plugin, right here I have enabled the plugin Moodle. And I'm saving it. I'm going to moodle.org. Right here, you can see the option downloading the latest version of Moodle to your server. You can use Moodle by downloading the latest version of to your server. Once it's downloaded to the server, you can go to Fedina page, Administration, Settings. In general settings, there is an option where we need to enter the Moodle URL. You will derive the URL from the server where you have installed it. And you need to enter the URL right here with the URL of the Moodle/Moodle. Once it's done and updated, you can use Moodle through Fedina. Moodle will provide us the functionality of letting the students in Fedina use Moodle without creating a new ID and password. You can use Fedina to access Moodle. Let's move to the next plugin, mobile plugin. You can use Fedina in mobile. The mobile version of Fedina can be used by enabling the plugin mobile. I'm enabling the plugin mobile and I'm using the same URL of my school in my mobile browser. When I open it in my mobile browser, I can log in as a student, admin, an employee, as well a parent. So let me show you few screenshots of the mobile version. Right here you can see this is how the mobile version will be. Once you type in the URL in the mobile browser, you will get to type the username and password. As an admin, if I'm going to type the username and password, I can log in and view the messages, calendar, attendance. Once you select the option messages for an admin, the admin get to view the messages that has been received for the admin. And the calendar will display the recent events that is going to happen for the current day and the upcoming days. As well, the admin can mark attendance by going to this particular module. A student can also log in into Fedina using a mobile version. Once when the student uses the username and password, here the student gets to see the messages that the student has received, the calendar where the student will get to see the events and any examinations or any holiday that is going to happen for the current day, as well the timetable for the student. The student also gets to see the attendance report, where the detail of the attendance percentage and the leave they've taken will be explained here. The next is the fee status, where the students will be able to see the status of the fees they have paid or the unpaid fee, and the amount to be paid will be displayed here. Let's see how a teacher can view a mobile version. Right here, as a teacher, the teacher can view the messages that is delivered to the employee and the calendar where the any events that is happening for today can be seen. The attendance module, where the teacher can mark attendance for the student. So employee can use Fedina in a mobile version in class to mark attendance. The next is the timetable. The teacher can view her own timetable right here. Teacher can also mark or leave, apply for leaves through Fedina mobile version, where it can be approved by the manager of the employee. So by going to the leave application, an employee can view the leave, past leave that the employee has taken, and select the leave type and apply. That's all about mobile version in Fedina. Let's move forward to the next module, gallery. Right here, I'm going to collaborations and I can find gallery. Inside the gallery, I need to add a new folder. Then I'm going for the option new. Right here, I can explain the folder name by entering a folder name. I'm saving it. Inside this particular folder or a category, I can add photos by selecting the option add photo. Here I can select a photo by going for the option choose file. The photo should have a maximum size of 5 megapixel. Here I can select choose and add, choose a file, say photo, and then give a photo name. I can also select a department by selecting a department here and adding the employees. I can select a batch of students by selecting the batch, and the students belonging to that batch can be added separately. These are the people who have given privilege to view this particular folder. Once I've done selecting, I can save it. Similarly, we can create folders inside the gallery and add photos, where only the privileged person, be it an employee or student, will be able to see, view it using their particular login. Let's move to the next module, OAuth. To enable Google OAuth, we need to enable the plugin OAuth in the Accounts panel. I'm enabling the plugin OAuth and I'm saving it. Once I've done enabling it, I need to go to my company, and here in the plugin settings, I need to enter the Google OAuth option where I need to enter the client key and client secret. Client key and client secret can be derived through console.developers.com. We need to select or create our own project, inside which, under the APIs and credential, I need to go for the create new client ID. Once when I select the option create new client ID, it's asking me to enter an authorized redirect URL, where here I need to enter the URL of my school. Let me enter the URL of my school here. I've entered the URL of my school / authenticate, and I can go for create client ID. Once I've given that option, a client ID and client secret will be generated for this particular URL. In case if it's a multi-school, you can create a client ID and secret for more than one school by providing the URL separated by comma. We can copy this client ID from here and enter it here as a client key and client secret and save it. We can also copy the client secret here and save it. Once this is done, let's log out and view that there is an option called sign in using Google account. By selecting this option, you can sign in using the Google account instead of signing using an username and password. Let's move to the next module, Google OAuth to Provider. This plugin will enable you to access for third-party applications or custom applications to use Fedina. Example of such applications can be biometric devices or RFID. If you have a hardware device, you will also have a software to understand these biometric IDs. So you need to have an hardware device, say any of these devices. It will also be attached with software devices. These devices will understand Fedina. So there must be a custom application. This will understand and translate it to Fedina, for which we need to use these plugins OAuth to Provider to integrate it with Fedina. Let's assume we have bought the application. Now let's enable the OAuth to Provider in the plugins option. Right here, I'm enabling this plugin OAuth to Provider and I'm saving it. In Fedina, I'm going to the option settings in administration, where I can find the option manage clients. Inside the manage clients, I need to create a new client name and give a redirect URL. Let me enter a client name. I've given a client name and I've given a redirect URL, and I'm enabling the option verified to let Fedina know that this particular URL is verified and certified to be used. Once I've enabled it, I'm going for the option save. Now, to integrate it with Fedina, We should also enable the plugin AppFrame, for which I'm enabling the plugin AppFrame in the Accounts panel and I'm saving it. Now let's go to the Apps option in the panel and I can find the option Manage Apps. Right here, I need to create a new one by giving the name of the app and the URL, say URL of the third-party application, and the client name that we've already created. It's asking us if this particular application has to be open inside Farina or in a new tab. We can select any of these options. And we need to select the privileged list of people, say admin, student, employee or parent. I need to select the privileged list right here by enabling this and giving submit. Once I've created the client here, in the apps you can find the client that I've created. So this particular application can be viewed when I select the option. And right here you can see the URL that I have given. I have given for the option to open inside Farina, so I can view it inside the Farina page. If I've given for a new separate tab, it will be viewed in a new tab. Similarly, we can create another one by giving the name and the URL of an application or a third-party software and give a privileged list of people. That's all about AppFrame module. Let's move forward to the next one, BigBlueButton. BigBlueButton is a plugin that will allow you to have online meetings using Farina. We can integrate this particular functionality in Farina by going for this bigbluebutton.org, where again we can download the application to the server. Here we get to try a demo version, as well download the latest updated application to the server. Now we need to enable the plugin BigBlue in the plugins option by editing it. I'm going for the option BigBlueButton. In Farina, I need to go to collaborations and the option collaborate. Right here, I need to enter the detail of the application that is downloaded in my server, for which I'm going to servers. I need to create a new one by giving the name, the URL and the salt. We get the name, URL and salt from the application that is downloaded in the server. Once these details are updated and saved here, we can create online meetings by going for the option new, where we can enter the name of the meeting, the server from the drop down. We have the option of selecting the department people who will be part of the meeting. We can once again select the privileged list of people by selecting a department. Right here I'm selecting a department. I get to see all the employees. I can select few of the employees or all employees. Similarly, I can select a class and select all the students or any one of it. I can select the date and time on which it has to be scheduled and schedule a meeting right here. The privileged employees and students who are part of a meeting will be having the same online meeting option plugin in their particular login, and they can view the timings and date for this online meeting. The next plugin that we have to see is Pay, which is nothing but the online payment. Right here in the plugins, I need to enable the plugin online payment. To make online payment, say pay fee or any transactions using online payment mode. I'm enabling the plugin, I'm saving it here. I need to add online gateway providers to my accounts panel. So let me show you how to add online gateway providers. Here in my accounts panel, I have already integrated few payment gateways. I have already added PayPal and Authorize.net. Let me show you how to enter the detail of the payment gateways. I need to give the name of the gateway and I need to give the configuration fields that I'll be getting from the gateway provider. These are the name and the values that they give me for the configuration field. To add more configuration field, I can go for the option add field and enter the name and value of the configuration field. Variable fields can also be created by giving a name and the field type from the drop-down. Similarly, I have added few variables fields here by entering a name and field type. I can also add response parameters by giving the name of the response parameters and the parameter type from the drop-down. I can add more parameters by going for the option add field. Once the details are entered, I'm saving it. I've also created one more online payment gateway here. I can create more by going for the option new gateway. While creating a school, I can integrate the gateway option. Like I can assign or integrate the payment gateway by going for assign gateway and select the payment gateway that I want to provide for this particular school. I can select any of this and go for the option save. Similarly, in a multi-school group, I can assign a payment gateway option for a particular group. Say go for the option gateway and go for assign gateways. I can also select the school or go for the domain. Let me enter the username and password for this multi-school group. Right here, I can select the school. I can select the payment gateway and integrate a payment gateway for these schools in this group right here. Similarly, I can assign or integrate the payment gateways by for all the multi-school that I have in my accounts panel. Apart from integrating it in the accounts panel, we can also do it in the Farina page. Where in Farina, we can go to the online payment option. In the administration, under the online payment, we have an option to go for the settings, where these are the payment gateways that I have created for this particular school. I can select any of these gateway and I can select the payment option to be enabled for these. Say student fee, application fee, registration, hostel fee and transport fee. In case if I want to enable online payment for these modules, I can enable it right here and select the payment gateway and save. I can also create custom gateways. Apart from these, if I want to have more gateways, I can go for custom gateway. By doing it in custom gateway, it enables the school to use this particular payment gateway only for the school. So right here, I have created custom gateway. I've entered the name of the payment gateway. I've entered the configuration fields, variable fields, and response parameters. I've done the settings right here. Once the settings are done, we can assign it in the online payment option. Now let's log in as a student to use online payment. I've logged in as a student through a student profile. I'm going to the profile of the student where I can go for the option fees. Right here, I'm going to pay the unpaid fees using online payment. Here, when I select pay, it is asking me to pay with card. Now I'm entering a test data. And I'm entering the card number. Once I've entered the detail, I'm going for the option pay. The green represents that the payment is completed. Once the payment is completed, it will redirect to Farina page and we can see the option payment successful with a payment reference number. Now as a student or a parent, we can print the receipt by going for the option print receipt here. The receipt is created here where we can see the name of the student, the admission number, roll number, the payment mode, the amount that the student has paid, now we are done with online payment. Let's go for the next module, blog. To go for this particular module, we need to enable the plugin in the accounts panel. In the accounts panel, plugins, I'm enabling the particular plugin blog. I'm saving it. Once I've enabled it, I can open the blog plugin only as an employee. As an admin, I cannot create blogs. I can only view blogs. So let me log out. Let me log in as an employee right now. I'm going to collaborations where I find the plugin blog. Here, I can create my blog by going for the option my blogs. Or these are the blogs that I'll be creating. So this will display the list of blogs that I create. I can create a new blog by giving a name for it. And I can add post under this particular blog by going for the option new post. Here, I can enter the title, I can enter the body of the blog. Say for example, I'm entering a title. I can enter the text data or I can attach an image or a video by going for these options. I can also give a hyperlink by selecting these. So let me enter random data and I'm going for the option publish. Now the blog is published and all the users will be able to view it. I can go for activities and view the recent activities. I can add more blogs, say more posts under this particular blog by going for new post. Let me log in as a student and view this particular blog that the employee has created. Under the collaborations, I can find the plugin blogs. And now I can see the blog that was created by the employee Karthik is visible here. I can open it and I can read the content. I can even comment back by entering a text here and giving the option submit. This particular comment will be viewed by everyone. As well, I can make it my favorite by selecting this option. I can also create my own blog as a student by going for this option, My Blog. Once again, we can enter the name of the blog and enter content to the particular blog. We can search for the blogs that is already created and or view the activities that has happened before. It's all about the plugin blogs. Let's move forward to the next plugin assignment. To use the plugin assignment, we need to enable the plugin in the accounts panel. I've enabled the plugin assignment here. Once it's done, I'm logging in to Fedina as an employee. Only an employee can create assignment for the subjects that they're taking. So let me log in as an employee. Under the academics option, I can find the assignment. Over here, I can create a new assignment or view the assignment that is already created by this particular employee. So since the employee hasn't created any assignments as before, I'm creating a new assignment by going for the option create new assignment. The employee can provide a title for the assignment. And select the particular subject, say particular subject for the batch and the class. So right here I'm selecting the subject for the batch class 1A section. So these are the students who belong to that particular batch. So all these names are listed here. That is the reason for selecting the subject here. I can select few students or all these students. Right here I'm selecting all the students. And I need to enter the content of the assignment. Once I've entered the content here, I can also attach a file by going for choose file and upload a file. As an employee, I can select the due date of the assignment. So by default, the due date is selected after a week, but the employee can change the due date to be any other day and create the new assignment. Now the new assignment is created and the students for whom the assignments were created can reply to this assignment. So let me log in as one of the students for whom the assignment was created. Right here, I'm going for the option academics and assignment. I can see the assignment, English assignment, which is created by the employee now. And I can see the due date as well. Let me open the assignment. I can see the content that the employee has provided for the assignment. As a student, I can answer to this assignment by going for the option answer this assignment. Here, I can give the title and the content. The student can reply to this assignment with the content here and enter or attach a file by going for the option choose file. Once the content is completed, the student can submit the assignment, submit the answer that they have given by going for this option, submit answer. The student has submitted the answer. Let's log in as an employee to view the answer the student has submitted. I'm logging as an employee. Here, let me open the assignment plugin, in which let me select the particular batch for which the assignment was created. I'm going for the assignment that I created. Right here, I can see the assigned students were 5. I can select the view the students who were assigned to this assignment. I can see the answered number of students is 1 and the pending is 4. When you go for this option, you can see the names of the students who have still pending to reply to this assignment. I can go for the answered student. And here you can see the student name with the status pending. It represents that the employee hasn't approved the assignment yet. Now the employee can view the assignment by selecting name of the student, and you can see the answer that the student has replied for. You can see the name of the student, you can see the time or the date in which the student replied for this assignment. Once the employee finds that his assignment is correct, he or she can go for the option accept answer or reject answer. Once the assignment is rejected, again the student needs to reply to the same assignment with a correct answer. If the employee is satisfied with the answer, they can go for the option accept answer. Now the assignment is accepted. Again in the status, we can find the answered one is 1 and the pending to be 4. Since there were 4 students who haven't replied to the assignment. Similarly, the assignment module can be used to make assignments for these students. We are done with the module assignment. Let's move forward to the next module, discipline. Let me enable the plugin discipline in the accounts panel. Right here in my plugins option, I'm enabling the plugin discipline. I have enabled it, so I'm saving it. In my Fedina page, as an admin, let me create a discipline using the discipline module. Under module, you can view the option discipline, where I can create disciplines by going for the option new. I've already created few. Let me view it. I've given a complaint number, I've given a title, as well as description. You can create a detailed description of the disciplinary action. So any disciplinary action that needs to be taken in the institution can be updated in this particular module, where the trial date, the date in which the action has to be taken, can be selected, or any judgment that needs to be made can be selected. So these are the persons who will be a part of this disciplinary action. Say complained by the student, you can type in the student name and add their names to this particular list. Similarly, complaint against will be the list of students who have been the victim, as well the jury we can select here. We can enter the name of the jury and search and attach. It needs to be an employee or the admin. The responsible officials can be the employees or the admin. So we can select the student or employee name by entering the name of the employee. If you want to attach a file to this particular discipline, we can go for the choose file option and attach a file. Once the details are entered here, we can go for the option submit. As a part of this particular disciplinary action, the jury can comment and the jury can give a verdict to close this particular disciplinary action. You can see the status to be pending. Let me give an official, as an official, a responsible official admin. I'm an admin and I can close this particular status by giving a verdict. I can give a comment here and I can go for the option close. So right here, I can give the verdict, comment and the convicted person from the list of students right here, and I can save. So this will be displayed to the employees and the students who have been part of this discipline. That's all about the discipline module. Let's move forward to the next module, data management. To view this particular module, we need to enable the plugin in the accounts panel, say data management. I've enabled here, I am saving it. In my Fedina page, I can open the data management. By going for data and reports, I can go for the data management, where here I can create the categories by going to the new option. These are the ones that I've already created. By selecting the category, you can enter the data. To create a new one, let me select new and give the names and description. So in case if I want to have the personal records of my employees with the ID number, see the employee ID, I can give the name of this particular personal record. Say I'm creating a field personal records, any personal record of employee, and I want these fields to be available there. Say field name, employee ID, and input method to be a text box or a select box or a checkbox. I can select any of this from the drop down. Once I've selected the input method, I can also create more such fields by going for add field. I have created one more field with the field name to be employee name and text box. So right now the data management will create a personal record option under which the description will be personal record of employees, where you can find an option as employee ID with an input method of text box, where the employee or the admin can enter the employee ID, and the next field to be an employee name with a text box where the employee name can be entered. For which I am creating these fields right here, I can also create or add another field by going for the option add field and give a field name. Once I've entered the field name, I can select from the drop down. Say any input method it can be. I've selected the text box since I need to type in the date of joining. I am giving save. Now, under this particular category, I can enter or add data by going for new entry option. These are the ones that I've already entered here. So by going for new entry, I can enter the employee ID, employee name and date of joining. Once I've entered and give save, it will automatically get displayed in my data management. So let me enter an employee ID. Once I've entered the date of joining and I'm saving it. Here you can find the recently entered employee detail available here. I can edit or delete it at any point. These are the employee that I've entered in the personal record field. So you can create more such categories by going for new and creating the category in which you need to enter the data. We can also go for the option print, where we can print the list of employee and their employee data. See, the personal record or the data management can be taken as a print. That's all about data management plugin. Let's move forward to the next plugin, Instant Fee. We need to enable the plugin Instant Fee in the plugins option. Right here, I've already enabled the Instant Fee. I am saving it. In Fedina page, you can find the Instant Fee option in Administration, Finance. Under this, we need to go for Fees. Here, you can find the Instant Fee plugin. Under the Instant Fee, we have an option of managing the Instant Fee. The Fees plugin enables us to create a master category, schedule it, and collect it from the student. Whereas Instant Fee plugin enables us to collect money from the student, at that instant, we need not have to schedule it, we not have to create. Like, we just have to enter by creating the category name and create the particulars inside it and enter the amount. Once we've added the category by going to the add category option, and under which we can create particulars by going for the option add particulars, where we can enter the name, description, and amount. I have given a particular name to be from the category that I have selected, the name, the description, and the amount. I can add another particular to the same category by giving a name. I've given the name, I'm giving a description, I'm giving an amount. I'm saving it. Once it is created, I can go for the option Pay Fees. I need to select the payee. It can be a student, it can be an employee, it can be a guest. I need to type their name right here. So let me type a student name. I need to select the student, select the category that I want to provide as an instant fee for the student, say the monthly fee that I created. So these are the particulars that I created under the particular category monthly fee. So it is getting displayed here. Now we can see the total amount. Say for one particular it's 1000 and for the other particular it's 5000. I can apply discounts if I want to apply any discount, and I can find the total amount to be paid this year. In case if I want to add more particular at the time of fee payment, I can go for add particular. Enter the particular name and the amount that the student has to pay. I can go for the option selecting the payment mode or enter a payment note and pay fee here. The instant fee is paid successfully. Similarly, we can pay fee using the instant fee plugin for all the students without scheduling the fee. The third option that is available is the transactions, where you can select a particular category, select the start date and end date, and view the list of transactions that has happened using the Instant Fee plugin. So using the Instant Fee plugin, I've paid fee, say instant fee for these students. I can view the amount, I can view the payment date and the payment mode. That's all about Instant Fee. The next plugin is the Fee Imports. To use Fee Imports plugin, we need to enable the plugin in the Accounts panel. Right here, I've enabled the plugin Fee Imports. I'm saving it. In Fedina, I can find Fee Imports in Administration, Finance, Fees, and I can go for the Fee Imports option. Right here, I need to select a batch. See, select a batch of student. Select a batch of student who has fee structure. So let me select one particular batch who will have a fee structure. Here for this particular class 1 A section, you can see there are more than one master category that has been created. And these are the students who are present in this particular batch. When I select a student, the fees category that is assigned for the student differs. In case if I want to change the master fee that the student has to pay, I can select, I can disable it, I can enable another. Similarly, if I want to change it for other students, I can do so. The other use of fees import is that after creating batches and creating master category for the batches, if a new student is admitted into Fedina or the school, the fees will not be impacted for the student. At that case, we need to go for fees import option and select the student name who have entered the school or joined the school later and select the fee structure right here. So if I want to provide this particular fee structure, then I can enable this and disable it. Where assigning the fee structure happens here, and once I've assigned it, the students will have to pay this particular fee. You can view the fees in the profile of the student. This can be done by selecting the batch and selecting the fee payment. That's all about the fee imports plugin. Let's move forward to the next plugin, Tally Expert. You can manage your financial transactions using Tally software. Let me enable the plugin Tally in the accounts panel by going for the plugins. I'm enabling it here in the Tally option, Tally Expert. Once the Tally Expert plugin is enabled, I can view it in the Fedina page. Right here, I'm going to Administration, Finance, where I can view the Tally Expert right here. The software Tally has to be installed into the server. Once it is installed, let's go to the general settings inside the settings. Right here, I need to provide the Tally URL. I have entered the URL of my Tally and I have given a live synchronized start date. So if I want the transactions that is happening in Fedina to be automatically implemented in my Tally, I can go for enable live synchronization. I have selected a date and I have enabled the live synchronization option right here and I've updated it. By doing so, it'll automatically capture the transactions that is happening using Fedina in the Tally software. Here we have the option of manual synchronization. If we don't want to go for enabling it automatically, we can go for manual synchronization by selecting the start date and the end date from the calendar and schedule it. We can view the schedule job here. Once the manual synchronization is completed, we can go for the option bulk export. Here you can schedule the export by selecting a start date and the end date and select the ledgers, say student fee, applicant registration, salary payment. So those kind of ledgers need to be created in the setting. So such ledgers will be displayed here. If I want to view the export that is happens, if I want to export a file where I can view the transactions, I can select these transactions. I can select a start date, I can select an end date and schedule it. Once the schedule job is over, I can find it in my downloads. But here I can find it as an exported file. This exported file will contain the transactions that has happened using the particular ledgers. Under the particular ledgers, the transaction that happened will be recorded here. And I can go for the option download, which will be downloaded to my browser, where I can view the export. We can also see failed synchronization. So any manual synchronization that we do happens to be a failed synchronization, it can be viewed here. By viewing it, we can once again select and do it manually. Inside the settings, we have an option to create the organization, voucher type, accounts and ledgers. To provide the organization name, I can go for giving the organization name here and add it. The company name will be displayed here. The voucher type can be created by adding the voucher name here. It can be payment, it can be receipt. So I have created a few voucher types. And we can enter the accounts by going to the accounts and enter the name of the account. I have created one account here. The ledgers can also be created. You can view the ledgers that is already created or create a new ledger. Right here, you need to enter the name of the ledger. I'm entering the name of the ledger here. And I'm selecting a company from the drop-down. These are the settings that we did in the general settings. Once I've selected the company that I've created, I'm selecting the voucher type. So let me select the payment option. I'm selecting the account name that I've created. I'm selecting the access account. And these are the transaction categories that I can select. So for these transaction categories, the ledgers will be created. So let me select few transaction categories like transport. I can create more categories and I can go for the option create. The ledger will be created right here. When you go for view ledgers, you can see the existing one as student fee with the voucher name, company name, accounts name and the financial categories that will come under the student fee option. You can edit or delete the ledger at any point. You can also create a new one right here by going for the option create ledger. Recently, I've created another ledger with the name transport V. I have given the company voucher account name with the finance category to be transport. So the transactions that happens will have this particular ledger. I can edit or delete it at any point. So that's all about Tally Export in Fedina. The next plugin that we will be doing is Poll. We need to enable this particular plugin in Fedina by going to Plugins and we need to enable the plugin Poll and Save. In the Fedina page, we can create polls by going for collaborations poll. Here you can create few new poll by going for the option new poll. I've already created few which is active as well closed. So this is how the poll that we already created will be viewed. To create a new one, I should go for the option new poll. Right here I can give questions, title for my question, description for my question, the answers that can be selected for the poll. And the members say the privileged employees or the batches of students can be selected here. Right here, I'm entering the title of the poll that I'm going to create. Once I have typed the title, say question, I can describe it in the description. I can give answer in the answers column. I can add more answer by going for add another. So I can enter the option that I want to go for. Say I'm entering a sample option. If I want to enable the privileged employees and student to poll for this one particular option or allow another answer also, I can go for this option, allow another answer. I need to select the members right here. Right now I'm selecting all the batches and all the departments. Let me post the poll right here. So now the poll is posted. You can see the active poll and the closed one. So I have not yet opened the poll yet. So the one that I've created is here, which is in the status closed. I can see the posted date and the oaths to be zero. I have not opened it. To open my poll, I need to select the option open. And now you can see the active status with the poll that I created and the oaths list. The list of voters can be viewed here. We can log in as a student or an employee and view this poll right now. So let me log in as a student now. I've logged in as a student and I'm going to view the poll that the employee or the admin has created. I'll go to collaborations. Under poll, I can view the recent one that was created. I'm opening it and I can select the option 1 or 2 as per what I've entered there. I have enabled the students to select only one of these options. So I need to select one and I'm voting it. Let me do the same as another student or another employee now. I've logged in as an employee and I can view the polls in collaboration. So in the active poll, I can view the poll that I've created. Here I'm selecting the option and I'm voting. Now let me log in as an employee or an admin to view the poll that I created. I'm going to the collaborations poll option. Here you can see the oath, the number of oaths that is taken is 2, and you can go to view the results. You can go for the option view results where you get to see the total number of oaths and the percentage of oath that was given for both the options. You can see the option 1, you can see the option 2 and the percentage and the number of oaths. You can view all the polls here. And now if the employee or the admin wants to close the poll, they can go for the option close poll. By selecting close poll, the students or the privileged employees will not be allowed to vote. Now it falls under the closed poll option where we can view the result of the poll. To create one more, you can go for new poll. That's all about the plugin poll. Let me move forward to the next plugin placement. We need to enable the plugin placement in the accounts panel. I am enabling the plugin right here. I've enabled the plugin. Now let me open the Fedina page. As an admin, let me go to academics and go for the plugin placement. Right here, I can view the archive placement by going for the archive placement. So it shows the old placement that has happened, the title, the company, the date, and the actions. So I can view the old placement. Select the generate report type, say the students who have applied or the students who have been invited, and I can go for the option. So here I can see the apply student report. You can also go for a PDF report. This is the Artshift placement report where I can create a new placement or announce a new placement by going for announce new placement. Right here I need to give the title of the placement. So if there is a placement drive that's going to happen in the school for the year 2015, I'm selecting the title and I need to select the date in which the placement is going to happen. And I can enter the company detail. and I can give the description of the placement. Once I've done with entering the description of the placement, I can create it here. This event is created here, and you can edit or archive this event at any point. Once as an admin or an employee who have created a placement, they need to invite students for the placement. It can be a bulk of students or few selected students, for which I can go for invite student option. Here I get to select the batch. All the batches are available here. I need to select the batch. I need to select all students or particular set of students. So I'm selecting one more batch. I'm selecting another student. I can do the same once I've invited these students. These are the four students who've been invited right now. So let me invite them. The students have been successfully invited for the placement event. Now we can view the registrations in this registration option. You can see these are the students who are invited and these are the batch detail of the student. Under the option registration, you can find the awaiting response for students, as well the attendance is not yet created because this placement hasn't happened yet. So let me log in using one of the students to view the placement option. I'm logging in as a student. The student for whom the placement was created. I'm going to Academics, Placement Plugin. So this particular student is not part of the placement, so the student cannot view the placement option. So let me log in as another student who's provided the privilege. Under the placement plugin, you can see the placement that was created for this particular company on this date. So the admin or the employee has invited this particular student to be part of the placement drive. So the student will be able to view the placement, and by selecting the placement, the student can view the invitation right here. After going through the detail of the placement drive, the company detail, the student can go for apply so that the student will be registered for this particular placement drive. I'm going for apply. Now, as a student, I'm registered to be a part of the placement event. But my approval as a student is still pending. So let me log in as an admin to view the application that I have done. So here I can open the placement that I created. I can go for the registrations. Here I can see the student has been invited and has been approved by the student, and the approve registration or reject registration option is available right here. So now the student has registered for the placement drive, and as an employee or admin, I have the privilege to approve or reject the registration. I can approve it, and here the status is set to be approve registration. If I want to reject the registration at any point, I can go for reject registration. Once the placement is completed, I can provide the placement status right here. Once the placement is over, you can make this event an archive event by selecting this event to be archive. By doing so, the placement will be visible in the archive list of placement. We are done with the placement plugin. Let's move forward to the next plugin, Tasks. This particular plugin need to be enabled in the accounts panel. So I'm going for the edit option. On the task plugin is update here. So once it's enabled, let me open it as an admin. Under the option Collaborations, I can view the task plugin. Here I've already assigned few tasks for a particular student or a particular employee. I can view these tasks that was already assigned by selecting the task. And then you can see the status as mark is complete. Here I've given the name and of the particular task, and I can attach a file if required. And then the task status is still set to be assigned. So to create a new task, let me go for the option create new. Here I can enter the title of the task. I've given the title. Let me give a description of this particular task. So the privileged employee who viewing the task will be able to understand the detail of the task. I'm choosing a file. By attach file option, I can choose a file right here. I can select a department, say any particular employee or set of employees. I'm selecting one particular department. I'm selecting one particular class. I'm selecting all the students in the class. I am selecting the start date and end date for this task to be completed. Once I selected, and I can view the members of this task here. So it's a combination of employees as well as students. So these are the members who will be able to view this particular task and implement it. I'm giving the option save. The task has been created successfully. Now, the exam report task is being assigned to the students and the employee. Now, let me log in as a student. I have logged in as a student. Here I can view the task by going for collaboration and tasks. So this particular student who has been a part of this task can view the task that was generated by the admin. I can view the employee or the name of the employee who have generated this task and the date and the status. Say it is not yet completed, it is still in the status assigned. So I'm opening it. And I can post an update to this task. I can attach a file and post an update and submit it. So as a student or a participant of a task, I will not be able to do anything else apart from submitting the update. I can go for assign to option, where I can see the list of people who have been assigned the same task. So once I'm done with submitting update, the employee who created the task or the admin who created the task will be able to view this particular update that I've made. So under the exam report, you can see the update that the particular student has made. Now I can mark as completed when the task is complete. I can select this option, mark as completed. The status changes to be updated successfully. This is how we can create and manage tasks in the institution. So let's move forward to the next plugin discussions. We need to enable the plugin discussion in the plugins option. Here I'm enabling the plugin discussion right here. I'm saving it. In the Farina School, I can open the discussion plugin by going to collaborations and discussion. Here, I can create a group to add posts to it. In case if I want to view all posts, I can go for option view all posts. So these are the posts that has been already created. Let me select one and show you how the post works. I've given a name, say English Club members. So this particular post is a only meant for the privileged employees of the department English and a set of students. I have given a description about this particular post and I have selected the employees and students to be a part of this group. So all the employees will have the privilege to add their comment and view the comment that is happening. So this particular student has replied to this comment saying they shall meet at 5 o'clock in the block A. Similarly, all the employees and students can add their own comments here, where the discussions will be viewed by all the privileged students and employees. As a privileged student or as a privileged employee, let me log in and view this particular discussion. So let me log in as one of the employee who's been given the privilege. So right here, I'm going to collaborations to view the discussion. Here you can see the English club members discussion. I can add my comment and I can view the comments that is happening. It already happened and all the participants of this particular discussions can view these discussions at any point. Let me log in as an admin right now. Let me open the discussion to show how to create a new discussion. I'm creating a new group where I'm giving a name for this particular group. And I'm selecting a department, say one particular department I'm selecting, and then I'm selecting the employees under the department, whereas I'm not selecting the class or the student. Once I'm done with it, I'm giving save. Here the group is created and the title and the description of the discussion to be made has to be typed now. So let me enter a discussion title and I'm entering the description of this particular discussion. I've entered a description and I can also upload an image or a document by going for choose file. I can go for the option post. Now all the members will be able to view the post that was created right now. They will have the privilege to comment back and view the comment that was added to the post at any point. That's all about this particular plugin discussion. Let's move forward to the next plugin, Document Manager. To open a Document Manager plugin, we need to enable the plugin in our accounts panel. I've already enabled the plugin Document Manager. So here you can see the Doc Manager enabled here and I'm saving it. I can view the plugin as an admin or as an employee. Let me go to say documents under the collaborations where we have the option of adding our documents and sharing it with a privileged set of employees or users. It can be any kind of user, be it an employee or a student. So here I can create a new folder by going for the option create folders where I can select this folder to be viewed only by a set of people. So right here, I'm selecting the users by selecting a department and the employee. Similarly, I can select a batch and I can select the student. So these are the members who will be viewing this particular folder. I can give a name for this folder. Say for example, and I'm attaching a file. So let me attach a file. I can go for another file by selecting the option add file right here. I can also delete the one that I've uploaded by selecting the cross. So I've selected the privileged members. I'm going for the option submit. Now we can see a document that was created with the name file. Under when I select that, I can see that the file is downloaded to my browser. So all the privileged students and employee will be able to view this particular file in their document manager, and when they select it, they will be able to download it to their browser. As an admin who have created this particular file, I can delete it or edit it. So let me log in as a student and employee to view the file that was given for me. So let me log in as a student. Now as a student, I'm given the privilege to view the particular file. Let me go to collaborations, go to documents, where I can view the shared documents. The admin has shared the one particular document with these members, and as a student, I'm a part of this particular group. I'm selecting the file, where again it gets downloaded to my browser. Let me log in as an admin and open that particular plugin. Here we've seen about documents and folders. We can create privileged documents or user specific documents. Privileged documents is just entering the folder name and selecting a particular department. Documents can be added to the folder and it can be shared with a set of people. User specific documents are meant to be for a particular user in Fedina, where I'm creating a folder name and I'm selecting the category of this particular user. The user can be a student, the user can be an employee. I'm selecting the student option. I need to enter the name of the folder. Let me enter the name of the folder. I'm making the status to be active and I'm submitting it. Now the active folders are created. Now you can see the user specific folder, user specific documents right here. When I go for this and search for a user specific document that has been uploaded. So I've selected the username and I have created a user specific document for this student or an employee. And when I search the user's name, I can view this particular user-specific documents. By using these plugins, an admin or the employee can save the student documents in this doc management, or we can also share a particular document with the set of employees in between departments, as well with students in departments of employee in the school. That's all about Document Manager plugin. The last plugin that we have to do is the email alert. To enable the plugin, we need to go to the accounts panel and we can enable the plugin email alert option right here. Once I've enabled this option, I'm saving it. In the Fedina page, we can go for this particular plugin email alert in collaborations, saying email. Here we have the option of sending email to all the employees or restricted set of employees. By going for the to employees option, we can send emails to students, guardian. So there's a setting option that we need to see here. These are the options that is available that an admin needs to do certain setting before using the email alert option. So the automatic email that can be triggered for these settings, based on these settings. So right here I've selected common event creation and I've enabled the option members. The members of the event, say an event is created, and the members who are part of the event will be notified using an email inside Fedina. When I want it to be enabled, I'm enabling it right here. Similarly, a daily wise attendance registration. See, a parent can be notified, so I've enabled the option parent here. Similarly, the employee creation will be notified using an email alert. There are other options right here. We can enable these options to make an automatic email notification. This will be an automatic and we can make this by enabling these options and save it here. For these criteria, we need not individually send email. It can be automatically triggered. The other options are nothing but to send an email to a bulk user, say a bulk employees, bulk students. I can go for two employees, select a particular department, select all the employees or particular employees in that particular department. I can enter the recipient, I can enter the subject and message here. Once I've done, I can go for the option send. Similarly, I can send mail to the parents, to students as well the guardians. These mail that the admin or the employee are sending will be received right here in this email option. It can be viewed here. You can see the event that was created by the admin and has been notified. When we open the event, we can see the description of the event, start time and the end time. As a user, as a privileged user of this particular event, I can reply back by going for the option reply. I can view the messages in my inbox, I can see my send items and I can also create a new one. So these are the messages or the emails that has been triggered by the admin right here. So that's all about email alert option. So we're done with all the plugins that we've planned to do for part 1 add-on module webinar.